there's a lot going right with your team, but the finished product just isn't there. Is that your assessment of what's been happening?
I don't think I can say anything else. Your words are the right words, and I would be worried if we don't create the opportunities. I would be worried if we don't shoot on target. I would be worried if I see my players tired. I would be worried if the substitutions are not coming in with the right mentality. And with all the things that I'm telling you are affirmations of things that are going well. But football, soccer, it's about scoring goals. And once again, when you create the chances, you have always opportunities to win games. And we have the chances. It's about the right timing. It's about the right decision. It's about knowing that you have that extra second inside the box when the defenders are a little bit more stressy. And I can't say anything wrong about the team who keeps on fighting until the end, but it's the same old story for the second time in a row, and it's frustrated. But on the other hand, I told to the players that it's only 7 games, a lot of games and points to come, and that we need to reach that break, that international break with a victory. We don't have any option. We need to go to Inter Miami and give our life to win the 3 points. But on the other hand, you know, it's football, and I'm sure that sooner or later that those opportunities will be reproduced as goals and in points. I could be a lot more worried if the way we play it's different, if we miss a lot of passes, if we don't dominate the game, if we don't have possession, if we don't create chances. And don't forget about the level of the opponent. I say it once again, and it's not a cliche, it's a true. Every opponent is difficult, but this team played together already many years. They have the same coach for the last 8 seasons. They are doing great. They know each other, and still against an opponent that on paper, on names, it seems to be better than us, like maybe Orlando is. Yeah, we deserve a lot more than nothing. So I don't have nothing more to say.
We'll go to Jason Anderson next.
Hi, Hernan. Obviously, you had to take Flores out of the game very early. Could you tell us what happened with him and what his status is?
I have no idea. I don't know what happened. He felt something on the back of his leg at the very beginning of the game. We treat Eddie this week as Maradona before the World Cup in Italy. And we took care of him, and we knew he played almost everything until now. We took good care, and we gave a lot of individual programs during the week to make sure he was fully recovered, and he was feeling fine, he was feeling 100%, and these kind of things can happen. I don't know if it's the weather, I don't know if it's hydration, I don't know if it's the fact that he took his second shot this week. I really don't know. Can be so many factors, but unlucky, he has to leave the game very early, and hopefully it's not a big injury, but no idea what is the right diagnosis.
We'll go to John Rojas. John, go ahead.
Thanks, Sakharan. Es la misma frustración, digamos, la que los va a llevar a seguir dando y dando y dando porque las cosas se ven en el terreno de juego bien, ¿no? Esa misma frustración los va a seguir empujando a que en algún momento se reviente y lleguen las que no han podido entrar. Y con Edison, me parece que también hay frustración en la situación física de Edison después de haberlo llevado bien durante la semana.
No, lo de Eddie puede pasar y le puede pasar a cualquier jugador. Él va a ser papá el jueves que viene. Y hay una serie de factores que pueden haber jugado y creado un efecto en la lesión. La verdad que no lo sé. Es muy triste porque es un jugador importante, pero todavía no sabemos el resultado, así que esperemos que sea algo leve y que pueda recuperarse pronto. Y en cuanto a lo primero que mencionás, frustración por no hacer el gol, pero la satisfacción de saber que todo lo que se trabaja y todo lo que se pide, los muchachos lo están haciendo con mucha intensidad, con mucha energía, y que si nos vamos a rendir en este momento, que solo van 7 partidos, eso sería dar la oportunidad a un montón de otros equipos que han sido inferiores en el juego y que se han llevado los puntos. Entonces hay que seguir luchando, hay que seguir trabajando, hay que seguir creyendo. Creo que eso es lo más importante, seguir creyendo en que todo lo que se está haciendo es el correcto. La gente nos apoya hasta el último segundo, estuvo enchufada en el partido hasta el final. Y bueno, será cuestión de tiempo y de que haya un clic y de que haya jugadores en la parte ofensiva en que puedan comenzar a hacer goles y a convertir todas esas situaciones que generamos. Pero es una frustración positiva, si le tengo que dar un nombre. Y lo último que tenemos que hacer es rendirnos o empezar a dudar. La duda no es un buen compañero y esto recién comienza. Así que seguiremos luchando hasta que encontremos los goles y con la tranquilidad de saber que este es el camino.
We'll take one more question, Hernan. We'll go to Mauricio Gomez, last question.
Hola, Hernan. I just want to know the performance that you saw on Kevin Paredes. Thank you.
I don't like to talk about individual performance. We are a team and we win together, we lose together. Kev got another 30 minutes. He couldn't get more than that. He come from very far and we need to go step by step with him. So again, please, not only with the help we got from the bench, from Kevin, from all the players who came in. I really like to talk always about the collective and not about individuals, but I let you know that Kevin is on the right way to play week after week, more and more minutes.